Good afternoon. We had a quorum at the scheduled time. And this is Subcommittee to Study Development of Textbook and Teaching Materials for Kindergarten, Primary, and Secondary School. We now proceed to the election of the chairman. According to the House Rule 22 and the election procedure on Appendix 4, we now invite nominations, and it should be seconded by at least one member and accepted by the nominated member. Nominations, please. Whose phone is it? Is it my own? Dr. Priscilla Leung, I nominate Eunice Young. Who seconded the nomination? Leung Chi Cheng seconded this. Ms. Young, do you accept? Yes. Any other nominations? Let me count down to five. One, two, three, four, five. No other nominations. And Ms. Young is elected ipso facto. And now, can you come up, please, and see when to elect a deputy chairman? Thank you for the members' support. And we finally elected a chairperson after at the fifth meeting. So can we decide whether we need to elect a deputy? Oh, we see there you all said no. So we now invite suggestion on future item for discussion. Let me speak first. On 31st of October, and I outlined my plans to the previous chairman, and you can take reference to the letter I issued previously. On Appendix 3, we have this work plan of 5 points to school curriculum design and implementation, and also the textbook materials and school-based policies, and also whether in deviations from the intended objectives, and also to review the roles and responsibility of government schools and publishers in development of textbook and teaching materials, and also to review the mechanism, guidelines, and standards provided by the government and schools, and also to improve enhancing design and good delivery of school curriculum, as well as regulatory review mechanism for development textbook and teaching materials with the view of enhancing the quality and effectiveness of teaching and learning in schools. And five, to study make reference to this experience other countries and regions in regulating the design and delivery of the curriculum, as well as development textbook and teaching materials for kindergarten, primary, and secondary school. Besides your work plan, do you have any other suggestions? I agreed with the contents of your work plan. There's a major component on complaint handling mechanism. Recently, I received a case in which the student informed the parents of some of the outrageous stuff, and the parents who filed a complaint is quite worried. And the parent chose to complain to the legislative member instead of the district counselor. When we accept the complaint, we can only refer that to EDB. But why couldn't that person file a complaint directly? Because that parent was afraid. With that complaint mechanism as part of the discussion, well, for the part relating the content of the textbook, and we can explore how the parents or student make complaints. And well, however, they fear retribution. For example, the student may get ostracized or even afraid that they will be invited to leave the school. Would you have a dedicated topic on this? That is quite important. We have received plenty of parents' complaints. They seem to have nowhere to go. But I set up this committee. I hope that EDB can follow up, and also we can at least know more about the mechanism itself. Next, Dr. Leung. Well, the parents are not being handled is nothing new. Well, quite 10 years ago, a student was ostracized in school. He was in the top one student, and however he suffered a lot of setbacks. I agreed with Mr. Leung. Second, I received a complaint. Would usually assume the teaching materials while the pre-establishment camp is willing to speak about on them, that the publishers also had their own grievances. If they do not include the yellow commentary or those and the statements of the icon, and when they send their textbook for review by the ETB, they may get blacklisted. That the person responsible to review the textbook at the ETB, a lot of them are showing biases. Therefore, the textbook they approved could be subject to our criticism. Well, that is also that publisher's experience. Well, for the ETB responsible for reviewing correct textbook, we need to keep track and who is the most senior person in charge. That why the members of the public, from teachers to the publishers, complain of such problem. I came across that personally, that some of the office holders within their political inclination is quite biased. While I was following on the general studies, I think the EDB should keep a clean account. If we shall convey to the EDB and request them to send officers to explain what is the procedure for reviewing textbook and how do they review the textbooks. Next, Tommy Chen, followed by Kwok Wai Kong. Okay, I'm not sure if what I said fall within the scope of this subcommittee. Well, Chairperson, you probably heard from me a lot of times. What if for a school-based management or textbook or teaching materials? For we have inspections by the school management, and the EDB also send inspectors to schools. Well, when you're in a suit, and I know I wouldn't say anything biased. I will just stick to the textbooks. Well, how are you going to inspect all the lesson hours that teach? When I was in university, well, back then before you were born, in the 1960s, we don't meant to scrutinize what the teachers were teaching. It's just a point to make keep close tabs on those who didn't show up for class due to various reasons, so that the students could actually keep up their reading in library and so on. When I first float this problem, maybe for the primary or secondary schools, well, not kindergartners, because in a classroom you can notice a lot of things. For the primary or secondary school, if we just took a video of a teacher's class, we not only wonder what is anything saying beyond the teaching materials. While when your prime kids need school issue, while you want to check what the teacher have taught, you might not need to hire tutors. You can follow up on the homework. You can just test in what have you listened. In the past, the management have no idea what the teachers are teaching and claim there's none of their problem. And then 2 weeks ago, the management of that primary school were also censured as well. Well, the management claimed that because they don't have CCTV, that means they are not to be blamed. Well, if the parents and the school management and the EDB can get hold of the recording, why do we need to make so many visits? I just want to check the recording or check the CCTV of the different classes instead of in-person inspection. That will save a lot of time, especially in the middle of this epidemic. I wonder if this falls within the scope or term framework of this subcommittee. Speaking of teaching materials, I think we need to make sure that whether the teachers are following the curriculum, the only way is to install CCTVs. Well, I see there's a good suggestion on the work plan on how do we look into the implementation and development of textbook teaching materials. Besides enhancing transparency, also protect teachers when they receive complaints. They also have a base. Well, whether for the management or the teachers, we can all based on evidence, we can keep a recording. It's not a it's not difficult to record the list as well. We should have enough budget. Well, let's just focus on primary and secondary school. It's a good way to leverage technology. Next, Mr. Kok Wai Kung. Well, first, I congratulate as being the chairperson of this subcommittee. I believe that those have a heavy task and also have a strong sense of duty. Well, ever since I proposed to report on inappropriate teaching materials and report on inappropriate behavior, I have been attacked online, and my banners have been attacked by black-clad rioters. Maybe you should be prepared as well. I believe that the colleagues present will not shrink. We will do our job. I agree with my colleagues before me. Then on the complaint mechanism on inappropriate teaching materials and teaching behavior, even though we're talking about policy but not on specific cases, from the complaints I received from Puiching Secondary School, the parents complain that there are teachers being advocating independence, and they are strictly following the EDB guidelines and file a complaint at school, and the principal refused to meet them. They also contacted EDB, and the EDB's reply claimed they have this enhanced school complaint management mechanism, which the school will handle first and the EDB will not interfere. That means that these complaints are going nowhere and the parents are frustrated. Who they can turn to? Should they reach out to the EDB or to the schools? Well, they are afraid of being doxxed when filing a complaint, and now they have been doxxed by the yellow ribbons. Even though I have talked about this case, how the EDB react to the complaints? If this complaint handling system cannot inspire confidence in the public, then who will make complaints? If everyone is afraid of the black-clad rioters, even though the law and order seems the black-clad violence seems to have subsided since the introduction of national security law, and parents worry that their training by the black-clad rioters have never ceased, and they're actually doing it openly at schools. They are waiting for time and ready to pounce any time and ruin our future generation. That's why we care so much about fixing the education and the teaching materials and the complaints. First, we have to enhance our complaint mechanisms. And second, these teaching materials will also cover online teaching materials. Hope that we can strengthen the supervision. And chairperson, one more thing.
考評局嗰啲考題都
There are also some issues with the HKEAA. Is that within our scope of discussion? Parents complain that the textbooks may be appropriate, but then questions on exams may not be as appropriate, and the students may need to memorize things that are not quite appropriate for learning. Well, I will discuss with the chair of the panel on education to see where we should discuss this topic. It might be better if we could discuss it at the panel of education because we do not have too many members in this subcommittee. I agree that this needs to be discussed. We need to look into the monitoring of the EDB. And many incidents have occurred. What are their responses? How are they going to work together to enhance this? I hope to know more about it as well. Next, Mr. Holden Chow. Thank you, Madam Chair. Thank you for giving me the opportunity to speak. All our members are concerned with the behavior on teachers, and I agree with what Leung Chi Cheung said, how we can better monitor the teachers to provide parents with a complaint mechanism whilst protecting their names, that they can complain anonymously. Madam Chair, since we have now set up a subcommittee, and I agree that we do have a lot of work to do. The EDB has already announced changes to liberal studies. The government seems to have set up some guidelines on changes. Although the EDB is looking into reform, we still need to ensure that the reform is appropriate. We need to make sure that this any kind of reform can achieve our goals, and we must monitor them to ensure that they can deal with teachers who behave inappropriately. Would you be also making sure that the EDB will include our views into the reforms? We want the EDB to really include what we have discussed with parents and to really make changes from the source. We want the EDB to listen to our suggestions, our recommendations, and include them into the reform. I just want to ensure that you would convey our messages to the EDB. Well, yes, I agree that the liberal studies reform will be a major change. And there would also be changes made in the textbooks, and that would fall within our ambit. I do hope that the Secretary will explain to us on what kind of textbooks or curriculum would be provided to the schools. We do look for more details from the EDB, and I will talk with the EDB to the government to see when we could discuss this properly. Mr. Cheng Chong Tai. Thank you, Madam Chair. There is a mechanism in the EDB for the school curriculum, but it has been criticized many times for its unfair guidelines and its non-transparency. Well, there is only a sort of general mechanism that publishers can provide textbooks for vetting under the EDB. The vetting panel would then make suggestions, and once approved, it would be listed as approved textbooks. So it's not entirely out of the mechanism. I just have one request. If possible, the vetting panel was not made known to the public on how they elect their members. Well, the pro-establishment camp is now trying to make changes to the development of textbooks. Would the vetting panel or actually those members who or the review panel on the textbooks all the members from that panel come attend our meetings? Because there is already a mechanism for the approval of textbooks. Well, if you think there is a problem with that, then you should make the names of members public. My request is that under this review mechanism, you should invite all members of the review panel to attend our discussions. Well, this seems to be under number two of our work plan regarding the development of textbooks and teaching materials. I hope that we will be able to invite members of the review panel to give us more information. Yes, I understand, Madam Chair. I told you about the mechanism. I want to know how they elect the members on the review panel. Well, rumors have said that they are very neutral and not biased, but now we are in different times. So I think that we should know who's on the panel and to see whether we could openly discuss this topic. Well, yes, since we do have a mechanism, we do want to know who sits on the panel as well. Second round, Dr. Priscilla Leung. Well, yes, whoever is in charge of textbooks and teaching materials should be accountable to us. I receive many complaints on textbooks and teaching materials each year. Well, there's a complaint on asking primary school students on what they mean by compensated dating. And they should explain what the term means and that people would date to get materialistic compensation. So we really want to make sure that we are on our way in taking the first step towards developing better teaching materials. Why do you teach such terminology to primary school students? And what kind of members do they appoint on the review panel? What is happening in society? Since we have received so many complaints, we want them or the government to let us know which publisher came up with these textbooks, who reviewed these, or who approved these textbooks. We want to know. Thank you. And Mr. Goh Kwai Kwang. A member said that it seems that we are going through cultural revolution right now. Well, but that is based on the premise that there has not been any black violence or student violence on campus. I don't think parents would want to see their own children learning all these from textbooks. Well, if you want to try to say or criticize us or denounce us, I don't think you are using the right term. We do have the responsibility to try to ensure that we are monitoring the development of textbooks and teaching materials and not to allow inappropriate materials to be taught to our children. Many newspapers or media now say that these people are already regretting it. Well, those sitting across from the room for us, are they regretful? They do not have to face any penalty. They just resign. They resign because they are afraid. But how about those who have been incited into inappropriate behavior, all those students? Are you really standing together with them? No. We are just trying to do what is needed to be done here. Well, yes, I agree with Kwok Wai Kung. We set up the subcommittee to protect students, to protect children. Parents do not really have a proper complaint mechanism, and some students are bullied in schools. We hope that there be a mechanism. Well, I will remind members not to use certain extreme words in our meetings. We all understand why we are setting up this subcommittee, to hope that schools will be neutral in the teaching of our next generation. We hope that they would not be too radical or too political in the education for our younger generation. I hope that we will all stand united in the subcommittee to do more, and then to sort of exert pressure on the EDB to provide clearer guidelines to the public and to parents. Any members who would like to speak? Well, I'd like to confirm the date of the next meeting and on the items to be discussed. I would discuss with the administration to see what they think of our work plans. And I will also relay your views to the administration. So I do hope we'll be able to discuss the items mentioned just now. Is there any AOB? If there's no AOB, I now declare the meeting closed. Thank you.